Hey everyone, Mr. Walker here. Just want to connect with everyone as the school year is coming to a close. We've had a solid year. We've had some students move up in bands. Many of us made all region, made ones on our solos. And so that's evidence that we're going in this direction. Now, we definitely don't want this guy, and this one is a nightmare. Don't want to go down. And so how can we avoid this? Brings me to my next point, which is summer lessons. When we skip that whole summer, it increases our chances of this guy right here, because most students won't have any accountability and won't be able to stay engaged because they don't have that extra help pushing them to stay there. So three reasons, three things I want to talk to you guys about. In the summer, reason number one why we want to stay in the lesson program is the students typically have more time available to them. They're not busy with their school day, plus the homework that comes with that afterwards, and any rehearsals, marching band, and all that stuff. So by having the summer lessons continue, we can capitalize on that extra time to get them stronger. Point number two is we're not distracted as well. The time that we have available is not distracted. Here's what I mean by that. We are in the school year working on all region, the solos and all those competitions and things. And so we don't really have an opportunity during the year to grow as much as I would like to push everyone, because we're dealing with the situation at hand. Here's the analogy. When is the best time for a football player per se to get more buff, to get faster and stronger and to better know the playbook? Is that in the middle of a game? We all know the obvious answer is no. It's too late. Whatever strength you have, you're going to have to use that in the game. And if it's enough, then you might come out strong. If it's not quite enough, then you might have to, you know, get it together for the next time. So for us in music, it's the same way, the same way. When August starts, we are in the game. Actually, it really starts in July in the band camp and stuff. We're in the game. The music has been given to us, and we have to now prepare for our obligations. So it's kind of difficult for me to help you guys grow to where you really want to be and where your directors are kind of aiming for you guys and myself when we're distracted with having to work on the assignments in front of us. So just like a football player, we got to do that before we get to the game. And so summer lessons help us with that. Point number three. This one is kind of funny. Point number three is just simply other students aren't practicing. The average student is going to kind of get a little bit lazy and back off and not practice during the summer. And so they're going to generally do this, while if we remain active, we're doing this. So that kind of like doubles your growth, just because the status quo is going to go the other way. So I hope those three reasons, you know, help you guys see the importance of summer lessons. I'll tell you this, most of the students that make, you know, all area or all state, first chair, stuff like that, most of those students are students that remain constant in the program. I can think of many students that just stay consistent throughout, and it ends up helping them excel like super high. So somewhere around this video, there's going to be a link that you can click on. So click on that link, and then you'll be able to get our schedule and everything going so we can get started. All right, again, Mr. Walker here. Great job this year. Let's keep capitalizing on that momentum for the summer, and I'll see you pretty soon in summer lessons. You guys take care.